Hello students, the new chapter we are going to start, that is cell. Cell is actually called as structural and functional unit of life. Structural and functional, why we are using this term? Structural means it is involved in making of different structures, different parts of the body. All the different shape, different structure in the bodies are actually made because of cell. And that particular structure is getting a function also because of cell only. So your lungs, lung is made up of lung cells which are having its own specific function. Same way different organs in your body is also made up of cell, but their functioning is different. So the cell is available in every part of our body. Now, not just human, but every organism on the earth consists of cell only. It's actually made up of cells only. Now cells are very small. So the small the size of the cell, it is not possible to observe under the microscope. It is the smallest, I can say. So we cannot see all this any cell through naked eyes. Now every old cells replaces every new cell replaces the old cell, and that's how the functioning in the body is continued. Now before having the study of cell, we have to study about the invention of microscope, which is being used to observe the cells, and then we'll go with the discovery of cells. Right now you can see one picture is there. It is actually a very very simple microscope. Simple microscope, why I'm telling? Because over here only one lens is used. And this discovery is actually done by a scientist named as Antoni van Leeuwenhoek. Yes, remember the term Antoni van Leeuwenhoek was a scientist. Actually, I cannot just consider him as a scientist because he was actually a public official, ordinary public official, and he worked on many different lenses. And in his discovery, he made one of the lens with a considerable magnification up to 200 times. So he made one of the very simple microscope where this is the two different views, opposite views. The front view you can see only single lens, we have to observe through that. But in the back view you can see the plate consists of a screw. This screw can be rotated because over here the particular object is being mounted. So that will be adjusted over here and it can be moved on this plate through this screw. So it's a very very simple microscope discovered by Antoni van Leeuwenhoek. Moving to the next part, it's a discovery of compound microscope done by Robert Hooke. Yeah, he was the scientist who actually made a microscope with two different lenses. Here you can see this is the one lens, that is a eyepiece. Another one that is nearer to objective, it is called as objective lens. And even he made some arrangement, he actually arranged a light source. For that he burned a candle, and here he kept a specific concave mirror. So through all this different setup, the light source from the outside, it's being taken, reflected into this setup. Okay, and you can see the object over which is kept on this particular board or on the stage. So this is a compound microscope. Now this Robert Hooke only, he took a thin slice of cork under his microscope. Cork cells are the cells in the stem of a tree, and these cells are available after a bark layer. These cork cells are dead cells actually, and he observed in the microscope a compartment or room or a box like structures. He reminded the rooms or the cells of the monastery what he visited. So he compared it with the compartments over there, and that compartments were called as cells, and later on he gave the term cells to all these boxes. So this is how Robert Hooke discovered a cell. Robert Hooke actually observed the cell which was dead, and he observed only the cell wall of it and a light nucleus over there. So it was a very very simple discovery of a small compartments like structure called as cell. Now this is compound microscope of the modern age. We developed it in this way. This kind of microscope only you can observe in your biology lab, having a stage, having two different lenses, some coarse adjustment, fine adjustment knob. Here it's a mirror, concave mirror. Afterward, the scientist discovered the electron microscope. You can see over here, it's very costly, and it's a microscope where they're using not just a normal glass lens, they're actually using a beam of electrons which is being bent by magnet. So because of this electron beams, they got success in getting magnification up to 2 lakh times. So because of 2 lakh time magnification can be possible with electron microscope, it proved very very important discovery in the study of this cells and its structures. Next topic is cell theory. Cell theory, major thing to be remembered. Just remember the three names: Sladen, Swan, and Virchow. Sladen, Swan, and Virchow were the three scientists who gave the different points for cell theory. Their points were based on the study of plant cell and animal cell only. The Sladen actually worked on the plant cell, and he told that every cell is the smallest unit of structure of all the living things. This is the first point. The Swan, on the other hand, was actually a zoologist who discovered, who actually studied the cell of animal, and he told the cell is the unit of function of all the living things. Last, the Virchow added in this cell theory that all cells arise from the pre-existing cells. So these are three points over here which are considered as a cell theory points. If you really want to study in detail this cell theory, then you have to go with with each of the points how it is being applicable. See, cell is a structural unit and functional unit of life. You can take example over here, it's taken about mango and the frog. All the parts of the mango and frog are actually made with the different types of cells, so they are making a structure of it, of their body. Even with that function also they are getting. If you can just consider, the movement of frog is due to the contraction of muscles only, and the muscles are nothing but it's made up of cells. The digestion of the food is taken place in the frog. It is just because of the cells available over there. Photosynthesis is one of the process occurred in the plant, like a mango, and they are making the new leaves, they are making the new food, that is a starch in the body. So this is how it is considered as a structural and functional unit of life. Even cell die and replace, every individual, like over here take an example of frog and mango, they are composed of millions and millions of cells, and that cells are continuously die and being replaced by new cells, and that is only possible by the process named as cell division. All life starts with a single cell. I think you studied before. Any single cell of a life is actually made by a fusion of sperm and the egg cell. Sperm and the egg cell fuses and forming a zygote, and from that zygote embryo is formed, and from embryo the remaining part of the bodies are formed. So every life starts with a single cell, that is a zygote. Now what are the number of cells available in different organisms? Is it possible the organism with a single cell? So yes, a single cell organism is also there. We have example like bacteria, we have example like yeast or amoeba. So these are the single cell organism. Few cell also, we have example of Volvox or Spirogyra, those kind of algae. And multi-cell, so you all know very well, it's a human being or plant or anyone, you can take the one those who are having multi-cells. Now size wise, if we can consider the size wise, the smallest cell is actually a bacteria, which is because it's having a size of 0.3 to 5 micrometer or micron. It's a very small size, not possible to observe even under through compound microscope. So that is very small size organism is available on the earth, and the size of the cell can be very very small, 0.3 to 5 micrometer. Longest cell, we have example of nerve cell. either the nerve cell you can consider which start from the tip of our finger till the spinal cord through our hand. That much long one nerve cell can be, or even the longest nerve cell recorded on the earth is a giraffe's neck, 3 meter long nerve cell. So that is a nerve cell. And the largest cell we have on the earth is ostrich egg. To be very precise, in ostrich egg, the yellow part, that is the yolk part, is actually called as a cell. That is considered as the largest cell on the earth. The white color part surrounding the egg is just a protein part. And the covering is made up of a particular shell. The covering is actually made up of calcium carbonate. So that we are not considering. We are just considering the yolk part. Now, how the smallness or the size of this cell, if it is very small, it is very efficient, or it is very much applicable for the cells. Every cell will communicate with another cell. And cells have a large surface area or volume ratio for greater diffusion of substances. That means if the cell is quite small, can diffuse the substances more as compared to the bigger cell. You are thinking, sir, if big cells are there, then they can easily absorb more amount of thing. But here, that thing to be understand, we have taken this particular cube. This is a cube having 2 millimeter by 2 millimeter width and the length. And the total surface area is, surfaces are 6. So total of area of this cube is 2 into 2 into 6 surfaces, so 24 square millimeter square. Now the same cube, if I'll divide like this from every side into the 8 different pieces, then you can get one piece from this area. See, from this, that one piece I'm taking, this is the one piece. Now this one piece is having 1 millimeter into 1 millimeter into 6 surfaces, 1 millimeter into 1 millimeter into 6 surfaces, so total 6 millimeters square. Now the same thing, I will multiply it with the 8 pieces. See over here, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Total 8 pieces we will get like that. So total 8 pieces into 6. So 8 into 6 will be 48 millimeter square. So we are getting now the surface area, that is 48 millimeter square. Where in the normal box without cutting, it is 24 only. So the small the size of the cell, the more applicability of the cell is there for diffusion of different product. If you really want to know this, here some points are given. Check these points. Here, nutrient into the cell can be easily diffused. Metabolic waste from the cell can be easily removed out. The respiratory gases exchange will be easily done, like oxygen will be taken, carbon dioxide will be given. And any damage to the cell can be easily repaired. For this purposes, the size of the cell should be small. Shape of the cells. The cells are of different shape actually. It's a disc-like, polygonal, rectangular, cuboidal, thread-like, branch, or even irregular. We'll just focus on some of the cells over here. What you have to remember. RBC, which is biconcave in shape. See, it looks like a saucer, how it is having a specific space for holding the liquid. Same way here, a space is there in the RBC. So it is biconcave structure, and it's the structure helping them for carrying more amount of oxygen and being easily transported through the blood capillary. The uneven cells over here, it is given its WBC, because uneven shape, irregular shape, that's why it is termed as amoeboid shape. Yeah, amoeba like, because they are also having the property, the WBCs are also having the property to squeeze out from the capillary. Squeeze out means the WBC can be a squeezing at the wall of capillary and will come out from that area. That process is named as diapedesis. It will come later on. The nerve cell, you can focus on the other hand, it's a quite long cells over here, and that is having a work for passing the impulses. Other than that, we have different types of muscle cells. The muscles, like here, the smooth muscle is given. These muscles are quite long, contractile, and having a role for pulling or squeezing the parts. At the end, we have a guard cell given over here. I think you know the guard cell. This is a guard cell having a green color because it contains chloroplast, and in the center you can easily observe the space or the pore named as a stomata. So these are overall different cells. Even after, among this, some of the cells are being asked in board exams also now, like the smooth muscle cell, might be this cartilage they can ask, might be the nerve cell they can keep, or the RBC, WBC they can keep. So you have to remember some of the shape with that name. Now we are going to focus on the very basic and very important part of the cell chapter, that is the structure of cell. And you have to remember the three major parts of the generalized cell, that is nucleus, cell membrane, and cytoplasm. Yeah, three. These three are the basic part which is available in all the type of cell. And after that, in many different types of cell, some specific parts are there which are having a specific shape, structure, and function. And based on that, this specific parts are called as organelle. So kindly remember the definition of organelle. The cell organelles are the specific part of cell having definite shape, structure, and specific function. Now, I want you all to draw with me the different parts of the cell. As we have considered the three basic part of the cell first, so we are going to draw that only. So I want you to draw the plant cell and animal cell at the same page with the same labeling. So first of all, the plant cell is approximately rectangular structure, whereas animal cell is quite uneven cell. So you can draw the cells like this. Now this you label it as cell membrane. So the first part, cell membrane, that is common. Second part, that is cytoplasm, that you can label at any part which is empty space, consider as cytoplasm. Any empty space you can just consider as a cytoplasm. Now you can draw in center or somewhat in corner, almost round structure, and label that part as nucleus. These are the three basic part we have drawn, which should be available in every different cell. Okay, now the first part we are focusing, that is a cell membrane. Cell membrane available both in plant and in animal cell. Now in plant and animal cell specifically, the cell membrane is the major part which is having a very minute pores which allows a selected particles to move inside the cell. Now as the specific part is there, specific porosity is there, based on that cell membrane is called as semi permeable membrane. So nature wise cell membrane is semi permeable, and the cell membrane is actually made up of lipoprotein. It consists of lipoprotein. Kindly focus on this, which allows a selected molecules to move into the cell or outside the cell. Now one specific part is available in the plant cell, that is actually called as cell wall. So one more wall is available specifically only in plant cell. This is cell wall, not available in animal cell. So animal cell, the shape and everything is being maintained by cell membrane only. But in plant cell, the rigidity and shape is actually because of the cell wall. Now this cell wall is actually made up of cellulose. The cell wall of the plant cell is made up of cellulose. That's why, you know, when we are eating plants, that means we are eating the vegetables, we are actually getting cellulose also. We cannot digest this cellulose, but the animals can digest, the other animals can digest. So in our body, this cellulose is working as a roughage, as a major fibrous material. So this cell wall is made up of cellulose, whereas cell membrane is made up of lipoprotein. Cell membrane is semi-permeable, whereas cell wall is freely permeable. Cell wall is freely permeable, allows most of the substance to pass through that area. So many molecules can easily enter or leave the cell through this plant cell wall. Sometime this cell wall only involves in making cotton, jute and coconut fibers in that specific different plants. Second very important part is cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is that watery, semi-liquid, colorless and transparent fluid available in the whole cell. The whole cell parts, that is the organelles, are embedded in this cytoplasm only. So this cytoplasm majorly involves in many different chemical reactions in our body. In that, amongst that, one of the reaction is respiration. Respiration, early step, actually it is named as glycolysis. That step is actually occurred in the cytoplasm only. So in that step, they are actually going to form one acid that is named as pyruvic acid. So that formation, that making, is actually done in the cytoplasm only. And many different metabolic activity are also controlled, are also regulated by this cytoplasm. You can draw the cell wall, which is only available in this plant cell, like this. This is how you can draw the cell wall, what we have already discussed. And this cell wall, I think you know, it is one of the freely permeable membrane. Now focusing on the main part, that is the brain of a cell, that is the nucleus. For that, you can make some changes in the diagram. You can draw one another structure in the nucleus that is named as nucleolus. And one another structure, that is a thread-like structure available in the whole nucleus, and that is named as chromatin fiber. Now in detail about this chromatin fiber nucleus and nucleolus we will discuss. Focusing on the main part of cell, that is the brain of cell, nucleus. Nucleus is actually containing the parts like a nuclear membrane. This is a nuclear membrane having a nuclear pore, internally nucleolus, and this is chromatin fiber. This is chromatin fiber available. Now, whenever you will see the structure in a normal state without cell division, then you can see in the nucleus the chromatin fiber only. But if the cell is going to be divided in the division state, you can see the chromatin fiber turn into this condensed form named as chromosome. So this chromatin fiber generally available in this thread-like structure, but at the time of cell division, it will convert into the condensed form named as chromosome. Now every part are having some role. Like nucleolus is having a role in the protein synthesis. Actually, protein synthesis is done by ribosome. So nucleolus actually involved in forming this ribosome also, and also making RNA. RNA stands for ribonucleic acid. The ribonucleic acid is later on involved in the protein synthesis. So nucleolus involved overall in the protein synthesis mechanism. Other than that, chromatin fiber or chromosome, both you can consider. Actually, it contains genetic information. Genetic information, or you can say hereditary information, because it contains genes. Genes actually encode for a specific character in you. It is responsible for a specific character to be observed in you, like your eye color, your nose shape, your body shape, everything is involved. So that is the role of chromatin fiber. Now, sometimes some particular cells are not having this nuclear membrane. Most of the cells are having nuclear membrane. Those who are having nuclear membrane, is called as eukaryote or eukaryotic organism. And without nuclear membrane, it is called as prokaryote or prokaryotic organism. Now, you know, prokaryote, we have best example, that is bacteria. Because in bacteria, nuclear membrane is not there. And the whole genetic material and nucleus is just roam into the cytoplasm. In human cell, the chromosome number is 46 in a single cell. So see, every single cell in human body consists of 46 chromosomes, that means 23 pairs. And this 23 pairs will combine the half of the chromosome. Out of 46, 23 number of chromosome from male combined with the 23 number of chromosome with female to form zygote. So I can just show you 23 from male and 23 from female combined to achieve the same number. What is there? That is 46. This is zygote. So zygote is having characteristic or the genes from father also, from mother also. So mother and father, both the characteristic are mixed in the zygote. And that's how we achieved 46 chromosome. Now, chromosome actually consists of, it's a condensed form of chromatin fiber. So chromosome or chromatin fiber are actually made up of gene. And that gene is containing DNA. That is our genetic material. That is our material which actually encode for hereditary information. Keep in mind, not the genes or chromosome number, but the types of gene decides the specific character in the species. Like lion, tiger and cat all are having 38 chromosome only in their single cell. Potato and chimpanzee are also having the same number of chromosome, 48 and 48. But the genes, what type of genes are available in lion, tiger and cat are different, and in potato and chimpanzee also are different. So based on the characteristic of the genes, the specific feature is decided. Now at the end, nucleus is having a major role for regulating or coordinating most of the part of the cell. All the organelles are being controlled by nucleus. It is involving in the process, that is cell division. And it contains factor, that is a gene, for determining the heredity. These are the function of nucleus.